Hi, I've got some really nice statistics prepared for you for this video. We will look at how does Bitcoin perform on a given weekday, on a given day in the month, on a given week in the year. So I have segregated the Bitcoin performance so we can try to distill structure. We try to find out how much does the Bitcoin price on average move in a certain time period. So how much volatility do we have? And also what's the average performance? So you look at this data historically speaking, that's not necessarily an indication of how it will be in the future, but I think it's still interesting to look at. So what I've used for this analysis is all the data spanning back from the middle of 2010 all the way to today. And the very first result we have is the average performance on a given weekday. So what you can see here, even though we've got that much data, that there's quite a bit of variation in the average performance. Saturday is by far the lowest with 0.1% average return on that day. Sunday and Monday is the highest. Now one thing to note about the statistics here is that the cutoff is at UTC time. That's typically what you get also in TradingView. So at midnight UTC time, one day finishes and another day starts. So that's right now 1 hour before London time. I'm not sure how this works with time shift, like in winter or summertime, but I think UTC itself doesn't change. There's no adjustment for winter or summertime, but that's what you have to look at. So on a Saturday, there is the least performance. On Sunday and Monday, it's one of the highest performances. Now, I was wondering, is this maybe because people just don't trade that much on Saturday? So what's actually the average price movement? So what I've done is I have looked at all the price history and I've basically taken the absolute value. So say there was a minus 1% day and then afterwards a plus 2% day. I would take the absolute values of both of those days. So basically plus 1%, plus 2%, take the average of that. So that's 1.5%. And this gives us a measure of how much in general the price fluctuates up or down. And so let's look at the fluctuations. So this is now the average daily price move per day of the week. And so what we can see here as well is that on Saturday, on average, the price moves the least. So there's not a lot of volatility on Saturday in Bitcoin compared to, say, Sunday and Monday. And so we can already see when there's not a lot of action happening on the Saturday, that this results in also less performance. So you want to have a lot of trading activity, a lot of price movement in general to also get high returns. The next chart I've got for you is the performance by day of the month. So is there maybe some kind of monthly rhythm in the performance of Bitcoin where maybe certain options are expiring or where maybe people dollar cost average into the market and maybe this kind of monthly rhythm has an impact on price. So that's the next chart. So here is the performance by day of the month on average for Bitcoin. So on the x-axis, you have the day of the month. And so we can see the first week of the month is pretty positive. So maybe that's when people get their paychecks. That's when they get their rental income. And so this cash flow gets transferred into Bitcoin at the beginning of the month. This seems to be a reoccurring theme. During the middle of the month, so like from 13 to 16, there's not a lot of action happening, not a lot of performance at least. The 31st has the best of all the performances. Now, I'm not sure if that's really because the 31st stands out that much and it makes so much performance, but not every month has a 31st, right? So maybe there's just less days to average. And since there's less of a sample size for those 31st of a month, there might be more fluctuation in this data. And just because there's more fluctuation, that's maybe why we have here the highest value. So I wouldn't give too much credit to this data point over here. But what I do like is that we have pretty consistently positive performance at the beginning of the month. And I do think this might have to do with people dollar cost averaging into Bitcoin. Now let's look at the average price movement. So again, the absolute values of the performance averaged out. So here we go. This is the average price movement. And I don't think we can see too much in this chart here. The variation isn't too large. We are always hovering around 3% price movement per day. And when we switch back and forth between the performance and the average price movement, I also don't see any structure or any correlation here. maybe what we can say is that during those high performance days, so the 11th, we also have relatively high average price movements. So this goes for the 11th. It also goes for the 19th. But I think the relationship is not too strong. There's not really a lot we can work with here with this data. But I think it was still worth it to just have a look at this. There's more charts to come, but please, if you haven't yet liked the video and you enjoy this content, please give this a thumbs up. YouTube will then share this channel to a new audience, and so the channel can grow and I can do more of these kind of videos. Thank you. One statistic that I find very interesting is, how does Bitcoin perform throughout the year? So are there certain months of the year where Bitcoin tends to outperform or where it tends to underperform? With stocks, you've got the saying, sell in May and go away, as in there's a lot of performance to be made just to the May of the year, and then prices tend to decline. Now, is there something similar happening with Bitcoin? That's what we're going to answer with this next chart. Here we go. That's the average Bitcoin performance by month of the year. And voila, we do have something very similar happening here. Sell in May and go away might not be too bad of a strategy, at least historically speaking. April and May have been by far the best month historically speaking. August and September have been dismal. You could have been outside of the market in the late summer, in autumn. People are not really getting hyped up about crypto when the weather isn't good. But when it's spring, when it's sunshine and rainbows, people want to buy crypto. At least this is what happened in the past. Now, this might not surprise you. The end of the year, we've got also quite a bit of outperformance. So you might recall that we did have these big rallies, usually around the Christmas time, right? The last bubble pop was at the end of the year in 2017. And so this is just another reflection of this. At the end of the year in Q4, we tend to outperform. During spring, we tend to have a big rally. And then in the late summer and autumn time, in the past, Bitcoin hasn't been too exciting. Now, if this theory holds up, what we should also see is that the average price movement during the late summer, autumn months should be lower, right? There's maybe just less attention on Bitcoin or on cryptocurrency in general. And people go outside. They're not stuck at home looking at charts. And so probably the performance here shouldn't just be less, but we should also see less volatility in general. And so let's look at the average price movement. And the theory seems to hold true. The lowest price movement in general is in September. And that's also where the performance is negative. So little action, little movement, no money to be made. A lot of price movement though happens in April, happens at the end of the year. January is not too bad either. And that's also where we see a lot of performance. April is doing quite well. End of the year is doing well. January is not too bad either. So let's flip back and forth. So you've got the comparison, performance, volatility, performance, volatility. What we can do now is we can zoom in further. So instead of looking at the individual months of the year, we can look at the weeks in a year. So from week 1 to week 52, what is our average performance in Bitcoin? And so what we're basically doing is we are looking at a higher resolution of this picture. We are basically adding some granularity. We will now have 4 bars instead of 1 for each month. And so let's look at that. This is the average performance in Bitcoin by week of the year. And what I like about this picture is that not just in terms of months, we've got this aggregation of performance here. So 2 high performing months following each other. If we zoom in and we look at the weeks, we also see that the single weeks themselves tend to be positive. So we don't have like big spikes over here and then a lot of negatives and spikes and negatives, but we have a pretty consistent positive spring performance here. And the same goes here for the end of the year, for the Q3 of the year. Pretty consistently, almost every week is positive. So it seems to make sense to be in the market during this time. Now, will this happen in the future? Who knows? But I do think that given that Bitcoin investing isn't yet too professional. There's a lot of retail money in it. There's a lot of accumulation money in it. Not a lot of hedge funds yet. Not a lot of people that actually look at these charts and that try to exploit those kind of structures. Because of that, I think those structures seem to have some validity to it. I do think that there is some kind of psychological thing going on here that can be used for profit. And so right now we are in June. and we are potentially looking at two more months that are not too positive. We are a bit of in a sideways movement now, right? We are hovering around 40K, not going down, not going up too much. And so this is pretty much also in line with what Bitcoin has done in the past 10 to 11 years. There's nothing surprising here, or nothing out of the ordinary at least. So by October, maybe we will see another rally, who knows? At least this is what happened in the past. So what we're going to do again is we look at the average price movement per week of the year. And here we go. We can see again a valley around the autumn weeks, and we can see a lot of excitement at the end of the year. Not so pronounced in terms of average price movements for the spring weeks, because the spring weeks, they do perform well, but we don't have a lot of volatility in those weeks, or at least nothing that stands out. But we can see this structure here, right? Little performance in autumn, little trading volume in autumn. A lot of performance in winter, a lot of trading volume during the winter weeks. Now I did one more thing. I split this up even by day. So we are not looking at month of the year or week of the year, but we are looking now at day of the year. And as you can imagine, we will see a lot of noise now because there's less sample size that go into each of those bars, right? And there will be a lot of ups and downs. And this is the chart that we get. This is the average performance of Bitcoin by day of the year. So we've zoomed in that much now, and we are looking at the data at such a granular level that this chart on its own can probably not be used too well. So what I did is I put a moving average on this, the 14-day moving average. And now we are almost doing the same as we did before when clustering this into weeks or into months. We are looking at this in aggregate again. And so we just have something similar again. The autumn is not too exciting. But yeah, that's basically what you get. So there is a limit to how deep you can dive into such data and still get something that's useful. So for completeness sake, let's also look at the daily price movements based on the day of the year. And again, an average around here. And we see a lot of activity at the end, not so much during autumn. And what's interesting here also, we do have a bit of volatility, but we tend to also see that the average price movements seem to go down during the year somewhat. But of course, there's a lot of ups and downs, so it might also just be a matter of over-interpreting the data at this point. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you haven't yet, feel free to subscribe. I publish a video 2 to 3 times every week, and so hopefully you will get a lot of value out of this. If you want to dive in even deeper, we've got a spam-free Telegram channel. You can ask me any questions there. The link to that channel is in the video description down below. See you next time. Bye-bye.